descendant of Clan Dunbrog.
My name is Patrick Doyle, and I am a composer. She's a very tomboyish, i.e. she's a very independent person. She doesn't want to be stereotyped. I treated it like a character, irrespective of if it was male or female, this is a character with a dilemma to deal with. And like every parent who has a teenager, whether it's a boy or a girl, you know, there's that feisty nature, but coupled with the fact that they're Celts. Two Scots can get together and argue all night, and people who don't know the culture can say, well, you'll probably never speak to each other again. I said, well, that was a great night. That was a great, healthy Scottish evening. Just screaming at each other about politics. It's just passion. And that's what's great about the movie. She's an extraordinary kind of character. Live action versus animation. For me, there's no difference. It's all drama. But in general, the same disciplines are demanded of you, passion or action or adventure or, you know, the romance in it. So it's still in the end music that has to be written down, whether it's symphonic, chamber or otherwise, or whether it's electronic otherwise, but it's the same dramatic demands a bit of you. It's character driven. So, but the movie really captured, unbelievably captured the essence and the soul of Scotland. I mean, there were many days I was just blown away when the rendered pictures of the lochs and the streams came in. I was very keen and brave to make it current and, I suppose, cool, as they say. And also to honour the Celtic tradition that I'm, you know, intrinsically part of. I mean, of course, I went back to listen to a lot of Celtic music, Celtic walking songs, i.e. these are songs that were sung. They're still sung, they're still walking song groups. These songs have a peculiar, they feel of Scottish snaps. You know, that sort of thing, you know. Apart from using the clearly the obvious and completely recognisable and, you know, irreplaceable Celtic, the flute, the Celtic harp, the whistles in various keys, and the bowrons and the various drum. I would like the tune. One of the cheap melodies went yum the diddle rum pa pa, and I would just hand that to the group. Was the Red Hot Chili Pipers. They were amazing, these young guys, thrilled to be part of it. Down they came, oh, to see them all warming up. I mean, four pipers in a big hall like that, sounding like 44. And I wrote a song with my son Patrick Neil, who's a really talented young composer who's studying now. Great, great talent. He's better than me, actually, and a wonderful lyricist. And he wrote the lyrics, the English lyrics, to the song that Emma Thompson sings with the young girl, the young murder, the duet, Noble Maid of Fear. And we had it translated by a guy I've used on many occasions, Donald McLean, who is a lecturer in Edinburgh. So hopefully that comes out, that these, you know, these melodies that I write, they have intervals and grace notes that come from the culture. It's not a sort of pastiche on it. I wanted the songs to sound as if they've been around forever.